introducing the flight goes on.
Some nights I wish that my legs could build a castle. Some nights I wish they'd just fall off. But I still wake up, I still see your ghost. Oh Lord, I'm still not sure what I stand for.
So we're here tonight to celebrate the 5th birthday of the Seagull Theatre. How many people have been here before? Give us a please. Now, I need to see a quick show of hands of everybody who's been here before, please. Wonderful. Wendy, hello. Next up is a fantastic theatre group called Faber.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are gathered here today
because the venue was unavailable yesterday, and the hire fee was too much for tomorrow.
That's not even funny.
I bring you a story from the good book. Not The Hobbit, which admittedly is a good book, and this book could easily go into three films without being dragged out to just get money out of the people that enjoyed Lord of the Rings. I talk, of course, of the Holy Bible, written by God, edited by Jesus, and illustrated by Quentin Blake. This is an important passage that teaches us to love thy neighbour and not take money.
I can't believe you paid £8 for this.
I'm doing a rehearsal for you. You might say, that sounds a bit odd, but we're doing a rehearsal. It's the Seagull Theatre Club, and it's going to be a rehearsal of a scene from Julius Caesar.
So what we're going to do is show you the scene once. I'm going to be making notes. I'm going to then give notes to our three actors, and then get them to run it again, and hopefully you'll see the sort of evolution of the scene.
Good morrow, worthy Caesar. I come to fetch you to the Senate House.
And you are come in very happy time to bear my greeting to the senators, and tell them that I will not come today.
Most mighty Caesar, let me know some cause, lest I be laughed at, and I'll tell them so.
The cause is in my will. I will not come. That is enough to satisfy the Senate.
Do, if we create a bit more space, and Mary, if you can come this side a little bit more, when you break away, Matt, you stay there, we can see you two in opposition. So Roger, you can physically move when you change your mind about going to the Senate from Marion to Matt, and then the audience can see visually that you've changed your mind.
Good morrow, worthy Caesar. I come to fetch you to the Senate House.
And you are come in very happy time to bear my greetings to the senators and tell them I will not come today.
Most mighty Caesar, let me know some cause, lest I be laughed at when I tell them so.
The cause is in my will. I will not come. That is enough to satisfy the Senate.
Caesar. I do hope the line is kept in. In for me, in for me. They've all got it. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Papa! £10 in this pocket. What have I got?
note someone else's trousers.
Hey. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it is my pleasure to introduce you all.
Take that.
Yeah. Now we've got to know who the snake really is.
Professor
by the dozen. They all will. Don't leave me. I'm your man. I'm the only one you can trust.
Do I know you, 274? Have we met? Well, it'll be lovely to meet you in the morning. I'll be sitting here with my cat and nine tails. And you know what I'm going to do with that? I'm going to strip you bollock naked and lie you on a butcher's table and flog you all the way to Crystal Palace.
That's where I am. I knew I knew the place. My wife's in bed. She's probably asleep. And I've got a little daughter.
Oh, you've got a little daughter?
Yeah. I think that's what she is.
Report to the office at 9 a.m. 135, where are you? Who the fuck is 135? 178, 246, 101. Oh, God. Where's everybody gone? I've got a job going down at Cuckfield. Can anyone hear me?
I can hear you. I'll be here.
And you've got to join in the chorus, because in musical times, all the audience knew the choruses, you see.
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you. So we're going to teach you the chorus, right? The pattern was blue roses, with its leaves red, white and brown. Passed up the wrong way up, and now we all walk upside down. And when he trimmed the edges off the paper with his shears, the cat got underneath it and he cut off both his ears. Oh, when coming,
here comes the
purple paste. It was down here, down here, paste and paper everywhere.
It's a sight of love. You've never seen a broken rabbit so stuck up before.
God,
oh, no, I am not God.
understand. We are not family then.
No.
But you have a family.
Yes, I do.
And you, Henry Kerbel, you also have a family.
Yes, of course.
And both of you know women of whom you will marry.
Well, I certainly do. I can't speak for Henry.
Yes, I of course know a woman I intend to marry.
Who is she?
It's a secret.
What is a secret?
A secret is something you are sworn not to tell anyone.
All right, now you've come. Hold still. Here. I don't want to cut you.
Is this good?
Everyone is different.
You are remarkable.
Victor.
You say nothing, Victor Frankenstein. Are you not pleased with how I look?
Of course. It will be better in time. Oh. Henry and I have to go. I want you to continue your studies. Learn everything you can. Don't be afraid to try new things. This is your home. You can do anything you want to do here. Do you understand?
I can do as I like. I am to learn all I can.
Yes. I mean, I have some important matters to discuss. We're going to have to leave you for a while.
I am lonely. I'm lonely when you are not here.
Thank you. with all of the different companies involved. She's badgered me at several points to give information on what the rep was doing, and as I said, it's such a massive thanks. It was a big task, and you just did it so perfectly. All right, thank you all for coming. I'll hand it back to you.
With a wonderful audience, a big audience, good night.